local humane society says the thief is responsible for stealing an estimated $700 from the agency and the public. 4029's Damon Maloney joins us now live from the Sebastian County Humane Society. And Damon, several of the nonprofit donation boxes have been stolen.
And Craig, the Humane Society's director, says she knows of at least three area businesses where someone has walked in, claimed to be working on behalf of the Humane Society, and walked away with cash.
It just really makes me sick, you know, particularly because we've struggled so hard this year to make ends meet.
Until just recently, the Sebastian County Humane Society was facing a $200,000 deficit. Executive Director Joanne Barton says through donations, the nonprofit is expected to be okay through year's end. But she's angry over an estimated $700 recently taken from donation canisters at the Pick and Tote number 2 in Fort Smith, the CV's grocery store, and Health Depot in Barling.
One of our board members went to pick up her canisters and they were empty, and they told her someone had already come to pick them up.
Barton says the bandit would take cash-filled donation boxes and replace them with empty ones. She says the loss of money hits hard and would have gone toward operation and supply costs.
We have to pay the electricity and the gas and water. It's a lot more than just food and cat litter.
Barton says the thefts will mean new security procedures at donation locations.
We're probably going to have badges that identifies who is able to actually pick up that money.
Police in both cities say they have a person of interest but have yet to name a suspect.
I definitely want to track them down and do whatever we can to prosecute.
At this time, police have not been able to get their hands on any surveillance video from any of the businesses where these canisters are suspected of being nabbed. Reporting live in Fort Smith, Damon Maloney, 4029 News.
Okay, Damon, thank you. Now, police say the suspect faces possible felony theft of property charges.